Oh, my. What a sight. Isn't that beautiful?
That's why the folks, and I can speak personally, that grew up in the Midwest dream about their team coming to the Roseville and somehow managing to make the trip themselves. The parade, the game, one of the great days in America. Third down and long. Tom Zach in the crowd. And number 54.
I think he lateraled that ball. Neil Hope, elected as the team's most valuable player and most inspirational player in this season. That's the first time ever for an SC player to have both of those honors in a single season. And in spite of the All-American honors by two outside linebackers, you see Hope right at the top of your screen, just saw his feet there. Watch him coming back now. That ball badly thrown by Tomaszak. That ball came out of his hand, didn't go anywhere near where he wanted it to go. I think this was a lateral, Dick. We're going to watch the end of that play now. But I believe that Hope tried to lateral that football right at the end. I don't think it was a fumble.
Over the Buckeye 45-yard line, and they come out with a reverse to Timmy Ware, and he has blockers. 45-40, and what a block! He's out at the 43-yard line. Dave Morrill made a good defensive play. When that set up, they had four SC blockers on two white jerseys, and didn't get more. It looked as if that might be a touchdown.
One of the things that Ted Toler mentioned to us when we talked to him earlier in the week, he said, we're going to have to throw some tricks at Ohio State. He said, we don't have enough offensive firepower to stay with the basics of the game. There's one of the tricks, and it was successful in its first outing.
That was Ryan Knight, the freshman tailback, handing off to Ware on the reverse, and he picks up 12 yards and a first down at the 33. Crutcher back in the game. And he's down to the 29-yard line. Pepper Johnson. Thomas Johnson from Detroit, Michigan. Ask him how he got his nickname Pepper. A number 98, the All-Big Ten linebacker for the Buckeyes, said, well, when I was a kid, they made fun of me because I made a mistake. I was eating cereal and I put pepper on it, and it's stuck ever since. He's made a few back sneeze during the course of this year as he led the team in tackles.
You saw him getting the defensive signals from Bob Tucker, the defensive coordinator on the sideline, and making sure that everyone got lined up in the right defense.
Second down, a long five. Green to Crutcher. SC running left and near a first down. Morrill again made the defensive play for the Buckeyes.
Cresselius on the left side, a little more active than Morrill, and they've gone over there quickly a number of times trying to run that power off tackle. Crutcher is not a blazing burner in terms of speed, but has learned to adjust to the blocking and to pick his holes. Vision so important for a tailback, especially when he lines up as deep as SC tailbacks line up. Look how far back from the center he is.
He's a good 8 yards back. It's third and one. It's Cormier in motion, and Crutcher goes right and has blockers. He has a first down at the Ohio State 16. Jim Palmer made the tackle. Kennedy Pola, 37, in front of Crutcher to throw a lead block.
There's nothing sophisticated about the basic SC offense. They blast the ball up the middle. They power the ball off tackle, and then they'll sweep the ball with a little toss right here. This is the toss play outside, the same play that's been run for years by this great Trojan offense. And right here, Crutcher does a job well enough to pick up a big first down, down on the 16-yard line.
It's tied at 3, 4:20 left in the first quarter. The Trojans on the drive. Here's Pola, the fullback. Little misdirection that certainly did not confuse the Buckeye defense. Chris Spielman from Massillon, Ohio. That mecca football talent. Earl Bruce found him there, and now he's a starter for him with Larry Kolick leaving the team at the end of the year. Spielman, familiar face. He's one of those Wheaties cover boys on the Wheaties boxes.
He had a frustrating freshman year, had ankle trouble, both ankles sprained during the season, but he's healthy after the layoff, and he is an exceptional player.
Second and 10 for the Trojans. Pass situation, but they go to run to Pola, and the big fullback powers inside the 10. He is 6'2 and 230.
SC doing a good job of recruiting among the Samoan population here. They do make great fullbacks, strong and totally without fear.
Pola just stuck his nose upfield and said, pull me down. Come on, come and get it.
If that name is familiar to those of you in the East, yes, his brother Al is a linebacker at Penn State. Third and a long three. Toss to Crutcher. A flag is down, and so is Crutcher short of the first down. Sonny Gordon came up from a safety spot to make the play.
Toler with the sun directly in his eyes. You see his, that's his ready list in front of him. He's using it to shield his eyes, but he has listed the plays by down and distance that he wants to run today.
Penalty flag apparently against the Buckeyes. That'll please Toler, gives USC a first down at the five.
Offside, the defense, first down.
The officials, a mixed crew of Pac-10 and Big Ten officials. The referee, Springer, is from the Pacific Ten Conference. And then they alternate as you go down the list, Pac-10, Big Ten. First and goal for SC, trying to break the three-all tie. Crutcher. Ooh, is he met? Solid hit by Anthony Giuliani, number 59. Talk about the fireplug build. He's around 5'11 and 248, senior from Westerville, Ohio.
You've got to have great inside-out pursuit to shut down that kind of play. But again, you've got to be careful that you don't over-pursue. If you do over-pursue, Crutcher will cut back against the grain. Giuliani, very important in that way, because he has to kind of maintain position with that back as he moves to the outside.
Green has a man open. Touchdown! A team that scored only four times through the air all year strikes in the first quarter of the Rose Bowl. Green to Cormier.
Look at Tim Green. Boy, he has pumped up. And Cormier from that Z-back position or H-back position trying to cover him with Gordon the rover. They couldn't hang on to it. Comes down with a touchdown.
Jordan's trying for point. He is good.
Joe Cormier coming from a wing position now in motion. Now one of the defensive backs moving out. You see number seven, Sonny Gordon, and he got bumped into really by one of his own men. One of the outside defenders coming back inside. Little roll by Green. Again, the left-handed toss. No chance to defend on the play.
And that makes the head coach of the Trojans, Ted Toler, more than pleased. The Trojans have the lead for the first time.
Okay.
Larry, just to remind you, and as we can do it any time of the game, you know, Toler was one of the members in that plane crash way back, Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, and he survived that. That's a little story that some might play in here somewhere. Yeah, yeah, that was a, what was the drive? That was after the interception. They went 45-8. Good start, good action. Program that? Can you tell them what that is down there?
Hey, can you program the time of possession? Yeah.
15.
Can you?
10 seconds.
I hear you.
4, 3.
They two most frequent visitors since World War II to the Rose Bowl. Ohio State trying to even its record at 6 apiece, and Southern California, more than any other team in the nation, has been here on this January 1st Classic, 17-6 for SC. In fact, they've often considered this their second home when recruiting young athletes in this area. But neither team has been here for 5 years, so it's a new experience for everyone on the field today. Woolridge will not run it out. Touchback at the 20-yard line. Well, the time of possession with Neil Hope's interception leading to a 45-yard drive and 8 plays. Green to Cormier for the touchdown. USC's had the ball for over 10 minutes, and Ohio State for just over a couple of minutes of this first quarter. Here's the 6'6 touchdown maker, Cormier.
It's got to feel very good, that whole SC sideline, at least at this far in the game. Thus far in the game, they have had things their way, Dick.
Now Byers going to try to change that, but he draws a crowd again, and it's taking three or four tacklers to bring him down, but all of them seem to be right there at the point of attack.
Working in behind that huge offensive line, and we mentioned them earlier. They're about as big as any line you'd ever bump up against. Look at the size of these offensive linemen. For Ohio State, the average, 6'5 and 269. And SC is even bigger, if you can believe that, in their offensive line, 6'6 and 265.
We'll see the Steelers in Miami on Sunday in the Orange Bowl. Neither team will have those
numbers.
Neither
team could match that, Nick.
Roman Bates, number 28 in the game for the first time, running back for Ohio State. Byers with a call, and again they surround him. 92 Colorado on top, but he had plenty of help underneath from Neil Hope.
The stress for the SC defense this week has been quickness. Get those tailbacks before they can really get started. And so far they're doing a good job of getting penetration and getting a hand on or an arm on or a shoulder on those big tailbacks before they can get their speed and momentum up.
Figures to be a pass situation for the Buckeyes. Tom Zach completed over 58% of his throws this year, 9 of them for touchdowns. Lanise in motion. And the hit made at the 27-yard line is going to be short of a first down. Mike Lanise, academic All-American from Mayfield, Ohio, is drilled by Rex Moore and Tommy Haynes, and the punting team comes on for Ohio State, and that's a story in this game as well. Tom Tupa, number 19 for the Buckeyes, a freshman from Brecksville, Ohio, he and the Buckeyes had the best net punting average in the nation this year, 44 yards a kick net. He averaged 47 a kick. So the combination of a strong young leg Tupa and great Ohio State coverage as the first quarter comes to an end. The score here in the 71st renewal of the Rose Bowl Classic, SC 10, Ohio State 3. I think we're kind of getting the story, even the, you're setting up the characters in this on a kind of a haphazard way, but at least we're getting them in. Yeah. Yeah. So it, yeah, yeah. You want to use that, you know, use that Bobby Moore thing, you know, to introduce him? Okay, if the, can you hear us, Ahmad? And we'll do it after a nothing play. We'll find a, like an incomplete pass. Well, look at that flag. Just the nicest little ripple. Super. Now that quarter's over. So fast. Yeah. No, we, I gave it verbally. I gave it verbally.
Let's go down and stay with Colorado on the nose. Yes, please. Watermelon from Colorado.
Did you ever show that matchup?
No, we never got to it.
Can we do it on that graphic?
I don't think we need to do it. I think we'll just talk about it.
Don't run it. Don't run it.
2nd quarter. quarter in Pasadena. Dick Enberg with Merlin Olsen. Southern California leading Ohio State 10-3, and Tom Tupa, the freshman All-Big Ten punter for the Buckeyes, will kick for the first time. Tommy Haynes, a Buckeye fan himself as a kid, Jack Tatum, his idol, will return for USC.
He's back there to return because Darrell Hopper, who did that most of the season, injured with a knee injury in the final game against Notre Dame, and that hurt not only the punt returns, but also the secondary for the Trojans.
You saw Tupa lick his fingers like a quarterback. He is a backup quarterback. Did not throw from punt formation this year, but sometimes coaches save surprises for the bowl games. Not this time. He drills it.
Not a good kick, though. A line driver.
Haynes at the 28-30 and steps out of bounds. They'll mark it around the 37-yard line. And we have a timeout just into the second quarter in Pasadena. 10-3 USC in 1969. The Rose Bowl game featured an incredible run, 80 yards by the magnificent Trojan tailback O.J. Simpson. It was the second quarter. Kurt Gowdy made the call, and we're going to share that moment with you when we can.
First down now for Southern Cal on their 20. They're ahead, 3-0. Soggy pitching to Simpson. 25, 30. Look out. He runs 109-4. They won't get him. He's being convoyed in. 80 yards for O.J. Simpson.
Are we going to have that kind of problem each time?
Larry. No, don't do that now. It's the wrong way. Take it out. Yeah.
Statistics. Ohio State with that long 50-yard run by Byers out rushing USC and out passing the Trojans, but trailing 10-3, and Green on first down from the 37, throwing long for Ware. Actually cutting in front of Ware was Hank Norman. He was closer to the ball. Ware, the deep man, was open.
Sonny Gordon, the Rover, back in the middle of that rosy country back there, trying to work one-on-one. This is not something that the Ohio State defenders have done well during this season, but Gordon on that play doing a very fine job of shadowing Norman, who is a very fine receiver.
I don't know who Green was throwing for. It's closer to Norman, but there you see Ware coming in the picture, and
that'll happen quite a bit today. Green is not the most accurate of passers today.
It's second and 10 from the SC 37.
Fletcher
at the 39 after a gain of just a couple. Dave Morrow makes another tackle for Ohio State. We pause briefly for station identification. Happy New Year from Pasadena on the NBC television network. Dick Enberg, Merlin Olsen.
Yes, I think it is.
Write that down for me so I can remember. 14-18 remaining in the second quarter. Ohio State trailing USC 10-3. A Neil Hope interception led to a Trojan drive for the only touchdown. That one scored on a pass from Green to Cormier, and Green to throw. Down the middle, has a man. Ware. Timmy Ware. First down at the 42 of Ohio State. Jim Palmer made the tackle.
Timmy Green swinging back, and as badly thrown as that earlier pass was, this one was right on target. Zipped it down the middle. Chance for you to see it at home. Ground level. Throwing right almost into your lap. Timmy Ware with excellent speed, good hands, cutting across to pick it up.
Ware, a senior from Compton Centennial High School. And that was a bullet by Green. We saw him practice the other day, and he didn't throw a spiral the whole afternoon. The toss to Crutcher. not quite able to turn the corner. Good lateral action defensively by Ohio State. Sonny Gordon made the tackle. Well, one man who didn't make it to the Rose Bowl as a player in the Pac-10 was Oregon's great running back, Bobby Moore. But he's here today, Ahmad Rashad. Ahmad is down on the sidelines, and apparently we have a little problem with communications, but we'll visit with him shortly. Second and five, USC. Green. Now he's scrambling to the 36-yard line. Looked as if he had a screen set up, Merlin, over on the right side, but couldn't find the man to throw it to. Him. Picks up a yard as Perselius made the defensive play.
Morrill squaring off with one of the Trojan offensive linemen. Motion's pumping a little bit out on that field. It was interesting to me the way these two teams were prepared. Ohio State kind of easy in their practices, didn't wear full gear. SC really popping. It doesn't appear to have had a great deal of impact on the style of this game so far.
Third down and call it five. Green overshoots his man. He had Norman open over the center, but too tall for his favorite target. He led USC in receptions with 38. A flag is down. Now we understand that the former Oregon star, Ahmad Rashad, is with us.
All right. I finally made it here. Where'd you get that picture? I thought I destroyed all of those.
You were 9-9 with the hair and 9-5 without it, I understand.
I had to get the haircut so I could play wide receiver. The intensity level down here is incredible.
Ahmad.
Go ahead.
Ahmad, were those high tops you were wearing in that picture?
No, they weren't. But, you know, I can't believe the size of some of these guys. When I was in school, none of these guys were half this big. I see why now that I got out of football. These guys are getting extremely too big.
Well, I know that you're thrilled just to be down on that Rose Bowl turf. You were excited 4 hours before the game today.
I had fun down here because, you know, the key to a big game like this, the memories you take on with you are the ones you get in the warm-ups. Because in the warm-ups, you can run as fast as you want to run. You can jump higher than you've ever jumped. And then the reality sets in when the game starts. But those are the memories you take on with you for life.
Well, Ahmad will be with us. He'll have interviews with the stars after the game. A penalty marked against USC has forced them back to third and 22. That takes them out of field goal range.
Face mask called it.
Green.
There's a duck.
Fourth string defensive tackle of the Buckeyes was the closest to that pass. And the punting team comes on for USC. That means Troy Richardson, number 99. He averaged 39 yards a kick. And Troy, named because his dad is a big USC fan. But Troy seems to fit quite right. He said, I never had a chance. If I was going to go to college, I was going to go to Southern California. Mike Lanise is back at the Buckeye 15.
Late drop by two extra defenders. Good kick.
It is a good kick. And USC grounds it.
Roy Richardson doing his imitation of a skywalk, a moonwalk on that one. Kicked perfectly downfield. SC had people in position, and look how quickly they get on top of that ball to down it.
45, Paul Green made the play. Timeout with 11:59 remaining in the first half.
Let's do Loudermilk now. Let's do the middle of that line because they're going to run for to try and get a little room in there. Loudermilk and Colorado.
What do you want to do here?
What did we say? I'm gonna give you. Let me come back at you. We'll talk about Indiana.
Okay. Joe, I can really hear you when you're talking to me.
Dick, as you look out into this crowd, I know there are probably a lot of people here who've been saving all year for this opportunity. You did your graduate work at Indiana. Did you have dreams of coming out here as an undergraduate?
But those years at Indiana, all you dreamt about was the start of the basketball season. But it's true. Many people have saved throughout the year. You root for your team, and you know, some way, as a student or as a fan, you'll find your way to Pasadena. There are thousands here who have made the trip, and I know many watching out across the nation today that have been here in Pasadena to recall what a great day this is, starting with the parade in the morning. Keith Byers wants to please those Buckeye fans. He has a 50-yard gain, but since then, he has drawn nothing but short yardage and a lot of Cardinal uniforms.
One of the most important matchups on that line of scrimmage, and you have to win down on the line of scrimmage. Colorado 92 against 63. Kurt Loudermilk. Loudermilk sliding to the outside. There they are. You see their positions right in the middle of that line. Loudermilk on Colorado. They'll be going tooth and nail all day today.
From his own end zone, Tom Zapp. Plenty of time. Now he throws long for Carter. Broken up at the last moment by Tim McDonald, number six.
Tremendous concern on the part of the SC coaching staff for the results if they have to get into a passing contest. They're concerned about their coverage people. Didn't have to be concerned on that play. Tim McDonald staying one-on-one with Mike Lanise, and he did a good job of timing his jump to knock that pass away.
McDonald led the Trojans in interceptions with four. Earl Bruce, in his sixth year with the Buckeyes, graduated from Ohio State in 53, was a football player but injured as a freshman, and Woody Hayes wouldn't let him quit school. He said, you stay here and get your degree. We'll find a way to work this thing out. Of course, Bruce now ultimately the replacement for the great Woody Hayes, head coach with the Buckeyes. On third down, Byers to the 10, but he does not get the first down. And again, gang tackling with Rex Moore, a freshman, number 35, leading the charge.
Both teams substituting their people freely. They want to keep fresh bodies on the field. And you see one reason for SC's eagerness to do that. Moore, who's gone in at a linebacking position, and another freshman, a great freshman linebacker on each side. Spielman, you saw earlier for Ohio State, and Moore in there on that play, but a lot of Trojans in on that tackle.
10 men on the line of scrimmage for USC. One man back, Tommy Haynes at the 45-yard line. Tupo will punt from inside his end zone. Short again.
Not a good kick.
Haynes up to the Buckeye 45 and down at the 42. So Tupo, highly heralded with the best net punting average in the nation, actually outkicked by Troy Richardson so far.
Well, both coaches were concerned about that matchup, expecting it to go to Tupa. Has not done that so far.
Timeout, 10:22 remaining in the first half in Pasadena.
Okay.
He only was held under 100 yards once, right? And that was when he was hurt.
I can't see it. Are you going to show it to me here? Oh, okay. Okay, let's not play it. Let's.
Next time,
yeah,
they,
yeah,
next
yeah.
time they get the ball,
yeah.
if you take the 50-yard
well,
gain
I think he knew because of the
away,
timing that they weren't going to be down
on top of it. How many carries and what his average is.
Yeah. Let's see.
That's really our story.
What?
Yeah. Seven for 17. He's got. Is that it? Is this what you've got? Is that what that is? 7 for 17.
That's a good stat. Byers, one carry for 50 yards, and since then 7 for 17 yards. That really kind of tells the. After 3 o'clock in the afternoon in Southern California. A beautiful day and lots of lovely faces at the Rose Bowl. USC leads Ohio State 10-3, 10:22 remaining in the second quarter. First down after the punt, and Crutcher with a call.
Spielman trailing the play, 36 made the tackle at the 39-yard line. Next, the big and bright bowl from Miami, the Orange Bowl, and it may well decide who is number one. I guess that still is in doubt, as you've heard in the poll taken by NBC. There are some members who will vote on the AP panel that would be influenced by a big Oklahoma win and would vote for them over BYU. Some say it's all locked up for the Cougars of BYU, but at least in some minds, that carries considerable significance tonight. That game with Washington and Oklahoma. Everyone's forgetting Washington's in that picture, too. Crutcher, not much at all. A yard at best.
I know that Bob Costas will be filling us in, bringing us up to date on exactly what's happening when we get back there at halftime. He's got his hands full back there. Today, all this football action.
Well, they lost him for 22 minutes. They couldn't find him under all those balloons, I understand. The 39-yard line, USC, in a pass situation. Third down and six. Cormier to the right. Way out to the left are both Norman and Ware. See if the Buckeyes bring some pressure. Ware. Tight ends, I believe it was Boyer, and that appears to be enough for a first down.
Jimmy Green did a good job of maintaining his composure back there on that particular play. Ran, picked up a little extra time before he finally found the man he wanted, zipped it in.
Boyer, 86, a senior from Huntington Beach, caught only 13 passes all season.
See Timmy avoiding Kumaro right there. Eric Kumaro, number 14. But there's the seam in the zone. Three defenders there, but none of them on time.
So Green's come up with some clutch third down throws for USC, and the drive continues. This one to Cormier, much like the one that scored the touchdown, to the 24-yard line, a gain of seven.
Well, it's certainly not pretty, but it is effective. And that's, we'll take our hat off to number 11, Timmy Green. He's had that kind of season. He's had some real problems in a couple of games hanging on to the football. Turnovers have been a real nemesis. When this SC team has had problems, it's been because they could not hang on to the ball. But Green today certainly doing an excellent job. 6 for 10, 63 yards. He's got the touchdown, and he has not been intercepted.
Second and three. Mistakes, and there it is, the mistake on the handoff, and coming up with the football is Chris Spielman for Ohio State. In their eight wins, only 18 mistakes, but when they lost, especially in the last two to UCLA and Notre Dame, 11 mistakes in just those two games, and there's the first turnover.
Well, and that's something you shouldn't make mistakes in. That little handoff just did not get the ball comfortably to the carrier. Reverse.
Lanise on the reverse for the Buckeyes. He's got blockers. Cormier flag is down as Lanise is in USC territory. But there may have been a clip on the Buckeyes.
Well, and you saw Mike Lanise bounce up off the ground, and he looked back and saw a yellow flag on the ground. Out of that wing position. Now, Lanise was converted from a tailback to that wide receiving position, and he still runs like a tailback. He scored twice on that little inside reverse. There you see the official. They're going to bring it back and march off a penalty against the Trojans.
That nullifies a 21-yard gain. Is Carter number two? Let's see if he was involved in that penalty.
Carter working on Tommy Haynes right there.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well, maybe it was later. We didn't see the end of the play. It might have happened after the fact.
Against the offense, 15 yards from the previous spot. Still first down.
Well, that amounts to a 36-yard penalty. 21 they didn't get, and 15 they do.
There's Lanise coming up off the ground. That's the reaction we talked about. He knew the minute he saw that flag on the ground that they were going to march it off.
Actually, from the spot of the foul, it's a 12-yard penalty back to the 21-yard line. And long, Tom Zach. Ooh. Almost intercepted. Four Trojans surrounding the intended receiver, Chris Carter, and Tom Zach was hit just as he threw the football.
That will not make Tom Zach very popular with the coaching staff, throwing that one right into the middle of a whole nest of Trojan defenders, and he's very lucky it didn't get carried back as an interception. Tom Zach under pressure. They're getting excellent pressure on him on that play. It's Del Rio blitzing from the outside. You see Bob Maggs protecting there, and one of the, who is that? That's 80. Pickett, that's the other linebacker. Both linebackers blitzing on that play.
Second and 22. And the screen, the Buyers, 20, cutting back. Look at the moves of this big man. And what a play! Talk about a mismatch, and McDonald comes up and rips Buyers down.
Dick, that's a classic way to take down the big back. You get them running east and west instead of north and south. Buyers running across the field. McDonald able to use his momentum coming upfield to take him down. Looking from across the field now, you'll see this play all the way through. Little throwback screen. Drops it over the head of the defenders. Buyers realizes there's no chance for the first down on this side. He goes all the way back. But look at him running sideways. Timmy Green can take him down there because he has no forward momentum.
A gain of just two, so it's third and 19. And Tom Zach gets it away in desperation. And that'll just get it back to where this series began when they recovered the fumble at the 33.
Dick, on that last play, SC had five defensive backs and five linebackers in the game. One defensive lineman. They call that their speed defense. They were able to control the long yardage situation, and they'll force the kick.
Woolridge with the reception, but good only for enough yardage to get it back where the series started after the penalty drove back the Buckeyes. Actually, it's third, now fourth and nine is Tupa to kick toward Haynes. Haynes back at the USC 25.
He's had two very poor kicks. Let's see if he can put his leg into this one. That's better.
Haynes drifting back. 18-yard line. And down at the 20. Good coverage by the Buckeyes. They've done that all season long. Pepper Johnson, 98, among those bringing Haynes down along with seven Sonny Gordon.
Well, it's a 48-yarder. He's had a couple of short ones, but he puts the foot to this one, gets it high and deep, allows his coverage team down to underneath it. They put it down 48 yards, very shallow return.
5:48 remaining in the first half. Talk about plays, Larry, that might be big plays, you know, that fumble, a 10-3 lead and moving into, you know, scoring position to fumble, you know, we might look back on that one.
That's a saber, that fumble play, if you can save it.
Says here, I haven't seen this commercial.
Larry, let's follow the SC line. Let's follow Rutgers out of the huddle so we can talk about the way they flip-flopped that offensive line.
Bob Hope from the desert. We hope you'll be with us. We understand Jack Nicklaus will be involved. Of course, Arnie Palmer and all the favorites. That's the weekend of the 12th and 13th, 4:30 Eastern time. We've got great tennis for you next weekend. McEnroe and Connors. We have the playoffs next Sunday in Miami. And unfortunately, apparently, a rather serious injury. It appears to be Martin French, 42. Reserve cornerback. Being assisted very carefully, and this may not be so serious, but the
cautions, unlike even when you were playing, Merlin. They'd just drag you off, wouldn't it?
Well, they sure used to be a little more careless about that, and I'm really pleased to see trainers and doctors taking better care of the athletes who are injured. No sense in having a serious injury when an athlete can be protected in that way. Ken Rector's big 77 up on the line.
Senior for Bakersfield, and he'll always be on the strong side of the line. Good balance of pressure. He just was staggering all the way. Picks up what appears to be close to a first down, about 8 yards. What is the use of Rutgers?
Rutgers on this play is cutting off on the backside. That's Dave Priscilius right there, 97. Rutgers' job to keep him from getting down the line. He's just like a picket line. He wants to keep those back people away in case the back crutcher wants to cut back against the grain. There'll be room there.
Second and two. Galloping through for a first down at the 35-yard line. Spielman made the tackle. Also Johnson on the play.
SC will kind of lull you to sleep. They'll go outside, out again and again and again. Now right here, that's Rutgers on Griselius again and doing a good job of pushing him to the outside. I think Griselius, anticipating the tailback to the outside, could not get back inside to even get a piece of Pola on that play.
Just under 5 minutes left in the half. USC with the ball and the lead, 10-3. Green to Ware. First down, Ohio State, 46. Spielman, the linebacker, drifting back to make the tackle. 18 more yards for SC.
When Earl Bruce left Terry White at home, he knew he was going to have some problems in that young secondary. You said it earlier, Dick. Two freshmen, two sophomores back there. And right there, Timmy Green will show you why it's a problem for them. He's finding room in that secondary. And Timmy Green able to throw that pass very nicely into him on that play.
Other games today, UCLA and the Fiesta. You saw on NBC 39-37 over Miami, and Doug Flutie and Boston College defeated Houston 45-28 in the Cotton Bowl. Crutcher.
Ooh, look out.
Pretty good hole for Crutcher. He's on to the 41-yard line. Gain of around 5 or 6. Giuliani trailing the play tripped him up. Reminder that later in today's Rose Bowl game, we'll select the outstanding player for each of these two teams. We shall make the announcement at the end of the game, and Toyota will donate a total of $1,000 to the school's general scholarship funds.
Dick, a young man on the defensive side who may be putting himself in contention is young Chris Spielman. He has 7 tackles already in this young game. And
that's the freshman.
He's got to be pumped up out there.
Second down and 4 at the 41. Crutcher again to the 39-yard line. Short of a first down.
And look who's at the bottom of that stack. Spielman, number 36, from his offside linebacking position, just shot over there behind that play and knocked Crutcher right off his feet.
6'2 and 223, the freshman from Massillon. How many great players and coaches have
Earl Bruce coached there himself for a while. Ted Tolner didn't.
He's been a West Coast man. Graduated from Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Oops, mix up. Green throws it over the head of Cormier.
Well, that's the kind of inconsistency that Toner's had to deal with this year for Green. He's hot and then he's cold.
And now we'll have to look at a punt situation, apparently. Toner, it's an interesting story, and he's a very fortunate man. He was a member of that Cal Poly San Luis Obispo team back in 1960, a plane crash in Toledo. They played Bowling Green, 22 teammates died. He was right at the wing level. Everyone in front of him perished, and he and most everyone behind survived despite serious injuries. So the man has enjoyed every day of his life. He figures that that was something that would influence him every day. Too much time by USC.
Now, there's a personal footnote to that. We had flown in my college days the same plane with the same pilot 2 weeks before that air disaster. So that one is fairly close to home for me, too.
Delay of the game against the offense. Still fourth down.
Troy Richardson will kick from 5 yards farther back, and Lanice will still stand at the 10 for Ohio State. 2:57 left, so the Buckeyes are going to get the ball with plenty of time to try to even the count. End over end. That'll probably go in the end zone. And does.
Almost a perfect kick, though. There were Trojan defenders down there. Had they been able to get their hands on it, they could have stopped it.
So 24 yards net on the punt for Richardson. And it's first down Ohio State at the Buckeye 20-yard line. They have stopped SC twice inside the 50, once on a fumble. And Southern California unable to maintain their drive on that last possession. Full day 85, and Bob Costas in New York. I'm sure he'll have some of the key plays from the earlier games and a look ahead to tonight's action on the Orange Bowl, Oklahoma and Washington. Tom Zach to Carter, and a first down at the 37-yard line. McDonald made the play.
You sense Earl Bruce. He says we're going to open it up a little bit. We have not been successful grinding on the ground, and he's telling them to hurry now. 2:40 on the clock left in this first half. They're in their two-minute offense already.
Fake to Byers. Tom Zach hit by Del Rio. Jack Del Rio, number 52, the senior from Haywood, California High School up in the Bay Area. Interesting heritage. He's one quarter Spanish, one quarter Italian, one quarter Irish, and one quarter Cherokee Indian. Put that all together and you've got an All-American.
Well, you saw the 55 sacks behind the line or tackles behind the line. He added another one right there.
Quick toss and a completion to Ed Taggart, the tight end from Akron, his first reception. And he stops the clock as he steps out of bounds. 2:09 left in the half, and that appears to be close to another first down.
The SC defense runs almost no man-to-man coverage, almost everything zone. They just don't have the personnel. And when they blitz people out of that coverage, they'll leave zones open. If Ohio State can find those zones, they'll be able to take advantage of them.
10 yards on the play, but with a loss on the preceding effort by Tomczak, it's third and a short two. Byers has it, and more to the 45 of USC before Jerome Tyler could ride him down. 9 yards for Byers, and the Buckeyes with their most impressive drive since the opening possession.
Still in their two-minute drill, they have not huddled. Tomczak, a good leader. Let's see what he can do here. He's gone.
Down he goes, and he fumbles, and USC has recovered.
Number 52, Jack Del Rio from the backside, from the blind side, and they're shooting those linebackers. They're not getting picked up. Tomczak taking a little extra time, knocked down from the backside.
Colorado apparently fell on the loose ball. Here's Del Rio.
Del Rio just drilled it. The ball bouncing loose. Tomczak couldn't look back to see where it was. You'll see Colorado get a shot at it on the ground. There he is. You see him spot that football? He'll go right down and scoop it up.
Ball right at the 50-yard line. And it's Del Rio's second sack in that series that creates the fumble, and Green with 1:50 left. And his own scramble. And almost State Spielman again. He's always around the ball as Fred Crutcher had to go off his fingertips.
Great speed. Spielman outside. That ball dangerously close to an interception. And that's one of the things that Ted Toler did very well during the early part of this year, is to quiet down Timmy Green. He was not expected to play, and he's still a very excitable young man. Throws that pass quite well under pressure, but the ball bounces off the hands of Crutcher, and you saw Spielman just about pick it up off the grass.
SC in a single back pass formation. Throws back and incomplete. Tight end Mark Boyer appeared he was looking right into the sun as he tried to search that.
I think he lost his feet too, Dick. I think his feet went out from underneath him. That certainly not the responsibility of the quarterback. Green gets that pass off, but has a little trouble after the play here. Chance to see it. Kumaro, number 14, coming from the outside, and 57, Dave Morrow. They're giving him a little work. Oh, Hey, he's a scrappy little cuss, I'll tell you.
He really is. Yeah. He's a talker, too. In fact, maybe a little bit too much late in the year, as he was bulletin board fodder for the opposition. He does not lack in confidence. Down the middle. Norman can't hang on. As that ball juggled through a couple of sets of hands, and the Buckeyes had a chance.
Almost intercepted, then almost caught, then almost intercepted again. Feel like you're right there as part of the action. Tim Green dropping back all on the left side this time, throws it right down over the center. First man there to bounce it up.
William White, 37.
Yeah, William White from the outside, a cornerback, actually. He was over quickly to get in on Hank.
Roy Richardson to punt. Lanise back at his 12. Lanise, a fair catch at the 10-yard line. USC again with excellent coverage. Richardson kicks it on very high, and the Trojans have had men behind Lanise ready to ground the ball or down it, and this time he wisely elected the fair catch at the 11-yard line, and still plenty of time, 1:26. So in the hurry-up offense used by Earl Bruce in their last possession, you wonder why were they hurrying so much with all the time remaining. Actually, it's worked out because SC failing to pick up the first down, and so the Buckeyes still have a minute 26 to tie it up.
Interesting to see how much gambling goes on here on this play.
Well, Tom Zach knows that you better watch out for 52 Del Rio, and here comes Del Rio again. Fires wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. It's taking three and four tacklers at a time, but they have certainly put a lock on Byers since his long 50-yard run early. Rex Moore, key man on the last play. Second and 10. Comes back. Intercepted by Tommy Haynes at the 25. California with a chance to add to the 10-3 lead.
Ohio State trying to exploit the secondary of the Trojans. They've been hurt by the pass over the year, but not on this play. Tommy Haynes, good reaction as he steps back inside, takes that ball out of the air, and he'll give the Trojans another opportunity to score.
58 seconds left in the half.
Mr. Iacocca.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations.
Beautiful day. Mr. Iacocca, congratulations.
Did you make it with no trouble? Mr. Iacocca's at the booth.
So it's a great day, great parade. What a wonderful event. What a nice honor. Congratulations. Keep your eye on Hank Norman, 83 here.
Next commercial will be the bumper, Dick.
Okay. Tell him I only need 10 seconds on that to get into it. Remaining in the first half, USC leading 10-3. The only touchdown scored by Southern California came after a Neil Hope interception, and the Trojans went 45 yards in eight plays. Green to Cormier, 3 yards for the touchdown. Now an interception by Haynes. USC has the ball inside the Buckeye 25. Fretcher driving inside the 20, a gain of 5. Clock is running.
SC has been averaging 6.3 yards per carry on those first down situations, doing a powerful job moving the ball. They're close to that on that play, almost exactly what their average is for the first half here.
USC has all three timeouts left, but are very casual about letting the clock run here. It's down to 30 seconds. With 25. Green throwing for Timmy Ware. Touchdown!
19 yards for number 19, Timmy Ware, and USC moves up 16-3.
Bob Tucker and his defense for Ohio State gambling. They came with the blitz. That puts the pressure man on man in the secondary. Oh, Bruce, not a very happy man on the sideline. Down 16-3, a chance to see it go to 17-3 here.
Four touchdown passes all year. 11 games, four touchdown passes, two in the first half today. Steve Jordan adds the extra point. Yeah, what a thrill that must be. Ware had only one touchdown reception all year, but he's got one in the granddaddy.
Just blowing out into an open part of the field there. Nobody even around him. It appeared, Dick, that William White was covering up short and expecting help deep. The closest man is the Rover, I believe, on the other side coming over, and he's nowhere to be seen.
So Tim Green, the feisty little quarterback of the Trojans, has his second touchdown throw and a 17-3 lead with 22 seconds left.
And a day of hot and cold, Tim Green certainly has had him hot at the right moments as he hits Timmy Ware for his second touchdown pass of the day.
Now Green is in the game and played the latter part of the year because of the injury to Sean Salisbury. He was the top quarterback for the Trojans, but injured seriously in the second game of the year. Green was redshirting, and they needed his experience, so he came back, decided to use his final year of eligibility this year, and led his team, certainly underdogs to do that, into this Rose Bowl, and had a great first half. Jordan to Byers, and Byers hoping that would go out of the end zone to the 30, but it lands in the end zone, so the touchback at the 20-yard line. Many Rose Bowl thrills, and all the greats in football history, or many of them, have performed on this field. And back in 1973, it was Sam Bam Cunningham.
Davis putting through, 10, he's gone! Anthony Davis does his victory dance on his knees.
Well, they said it'd be Sam Bam. I guess we'll show him another time. But his teammate Anthony Davis, he knew how to get into the end zone as well.
He did have the right uniform on.
Tomczak to Carter. And Carter out of bounds at the 43. And USC lucky, 15 yards not tacked on. It looked to be a pretty high hit. 23 yards in the play. Jerome Tyler made the tackle.
We may get a penalty yet. Well, Carter may be hurt. Lanise over quickly to see what's wrong with his teammate. Trainer across the field.
So Carter hit hard as he went out of bounds, and looked like that was right around the pads or helmet. Reminder that following our Rose Bowl activity here in Pasadena, it'll be Oklahoma Sooners and the Washington Huskies from Miami's Orange Bowl, completing our triple header of football action. And at halftime, Bob Costas will set the scene for you. A lot of mixed emotions around the country as to who is number one. And Doug Flutie, who's already led his Boston College Eagles to a victory in the Cotton Bowl, we'll see him on Saturday in Honolulu in the Hula Bowl. Tony DeGrate, the Lombardi Award winner for Texas, will also be in that one. And Merle and I are headed for Miami, where the Pittsburgh Steelers will meet the Miami Dolphins for the right to go on to the Super Bowl in Palo Alto, California. Carter is okay, comes off under his own power.
Good news for Buckeye fans. He's an important cog, and they've got to be thinking about how they can get themselves back on that scoreboard.
15 seconds left, first down from their 43. Tomczak eluding the rush, has an open man, Woolridge, at the 41 of USC. 8 seconds left. The Buckeyes have only one timeout remaining, and they'll spend it right now. Timeout. 15 yards on that play. Well, we were out here about 4 hours before the kickoff, and most of the folks were at the parade. A few straggled in the early morning, and bit by bit, the 100,000 plus filled this giant oval down in one of the little arroyos in Pasadena.
just like magic.
That's the one you sent home saying, having a wonderful day in Pasadena, another rotten day in paradise.
What a beautiful day. I live just a few minutes from here. I ride my bicycle down around this Rose Bowl. This is not a typical Ohio State outing. Look how many points they have scored on the season, an average of 34 per game. Much, much more than SC has averaged, but this has certainly been a non-typical game for both teams. You can see the defenses have both been tough during the day. So far, passing, Ohio State 5 for 6, averaging 13.3 yards on first downs. Yeah. Well, doing a good job on the passing side on first down. Not such a good job of running the football. SC has been tough against the running attack today.
Only 8 seconds left and no more timeouts for Tom Zapp. Looking for Lanise. He's got it. He's out of bounds. 3 seconds, and at least they can go for a long field goal, and that's exactly what Earl Bruce has ordered. 12 yards on that play. Lanise out of bounds at the 29. So this one will be around 46 yards for Spangler, his longest of the year, and for his career is 47.
Kind of pleasant to see a straight-up kicker for a change, isn't it?
Indeed. In fact, Lou Groza was one of the great kickers. The toe was his tutor for 2 years. 46-yard attempt. Boy, you can't kick that one any straighter. And the Buckeyes get three.
Big lift emotionally just before the half as time runs out. Spangler has given his troops a little shot in the arm. 3 points on the board. Straight into the ball. Up high and dropping over the goalpost.
46 yards for Spangler. That is the end of the first half. The Buckeyes can celebrate 2 field goals, but looking at the scoreboard, they trail by 11 as they head to the locker at the intermission. What are we going to do here now?
We have 3 minutes to fetch up. 3 minutes.
Do you want to go on the on-camera position now?